What's up? This is day 335. Make a Songbringer. Today I'm working on Gates in the Dungeons. Do we get to name stuff? Hey Zilton, I got a cool thing for you to name, alright? Lately I've been working on the overworld and looping through all these seeds and stuff. Let me show you what I'm talking about. I need more seeds, man. I need you to name some seeds for me. I need six-letter words. Like actual six-letter words. That's basically all I need. So like, there's this new feature of the overworld generator here where it loops through a bunch of seeds so I can look at a glance, like, see, oh, look, all these seeds, they're succeeding with zero retries, actually. What's up, Pedro? Oh, yeah, Pedro, you're asking about this and the retries and stuff last time. Look at this. I got it all the way down to zero retries for almost every one of these world seeds. There's only one world seed that has one retry, and that one retry is actually one where I was like, you know what? There's really not much I can do with code here to try and fix it. In fact, if I were to try and fix it with code, it would have probably just taken me forever and just wouldn't have been that fruitful. So basically, this is really sweet. All the worlds are now succeeding with zero retries. And they're a lot more interesting. The sand can be now placed all the way even in the home screen. So the home screen can look a lot different in some worlds, which is very interesting. You notice like all the dungeons are really deep here at the end. So like dungeon 9, dungeon 8, dungeon 7, those are always really deep in the worlds. The refills are always right after a gate. So as you go from one section to another, it puts a refill there. So refills are really strategically placed. No. They don't take longer. Actually, what was going on there last time when I was measuring the 100 milliseconds or so, that was when it bailed out of creating a world before it was finished. So these are all finished worlds. Finished worlds take about half a second. But if it finds a place in the world where it messes up at the beginning, then it's going to bail sooner. So that's why the 100 milliseconds only elapses before it can do that. Because basically, it takes like 100 milliseconds for it to develop to generate the world, the overworld. But then the rest of it, the 400 milliseconds, is the dungeons. The dungeons take some time too. So it usually what happens is it'll bail in the overworld. That'll be like 100 milliseconds. And then, you know, that's why. Arcane, what's up? Rock Jib, Wizafu, Baby No, I love you. But I'm looking for actual words though. I need six letter words. Alright, so that's not what I'm working on today. I'm working on gates, actually. So this is I'm looking at the dungeons. And I just wrote some code that makes it so keys. See, in this dungeon right here, this key number one, used to be placed right here, which was right where the door is, which is a shitty place to put a key. You should never put a key right where you're about to use it. That just takes away all the mystery of the dungeon. I mean, I guess it's probably good for speedrunners, but the point is, it'd be nice if keys were not always right next to doors. So I just wrote some code that basically optimizes that, changes the weight of the rooms that it chooses to put the key in. So it weights it so that the keys are usually not in a room that has a door that's locked, unless there's just no other possible place. So it's a good weighting system that goes on there. Quartz. Quartz. Jigsaw puzzle. Arcane, we got Arcane. Wilfrey, saw one, eat men. What about real words though? Real words. Okay, so I'm actually ready to check this in. Sudoku. Nice. Arcane's really awesome now. Check out Arcane. Arcane's a pretty good world. Raffle. There you go. Here's Arcane. This is what the overworld looks like for Arcane. Once again, zero retries. Give suck. But I'm in World Tuxedo right now because it's freaking awesome. Tuxedo's super sweet. Look at Tuxedo. You're impressed how neat my code is, right? It can be. That can be a good thing. Can be a bad thing if you don't have neat code. This is what's so cool about Tuxedo. Tuxedo has sand at the beginning. So look at Tuxedo's. Let me turn off the overworld generator and we'll turn on the player being in the world. Tuxedo's super cool. I love this world. Online within. Zebras. Look at this. This is pretty neat. This is like a totally alternate style for the first screen. It's like mountainous. It's got some sand on the ground. And then this is some sandy areas right near the home. So this is a unique world. So it's a lot different than most worlds, because most worlds have forests at the beginning. These are some other good words here. What are these? Online. Cheats. Zebras. Vagina. Vagina in there, man. That's gotta be in there. Cordyu is, I mean, it's a great world to test, but I wanted to put real actual six letter words here for the world seeds to flip through. Prizes. What's up, Aragon? Awesome. So just because you guys are all shouting out some awesome words here, I'm going to turn on this world seeds thing. So it's going to cycle through all these worlds while we're talking about it. Xanadu, Tuxedo, ZZQ. I guess ZZZQ is not a good world to test anymore. Not an actual world. Let's take that one out. Not an actual word, I mean. Buggy's not either, and that world is now fixed anyway, so we'll take out Buggy. Public crumbs. It's funny how when you rack your brain to, like, think of six-letter words, you can only come up with so many. Like, last night I was doing this, and I was like, wait a minute, all I can think of is like donkey, butter, peanut. If my shriek random number generator generates more than 4 billion whatevers you need, would you use that instead? No, I can't use it instead. I have to use a deterministic random number generator. Puddle. Barbie! Barbie? It's even harder if English isn't your first language, right? Okay, so I'm about to check in some code. Oh, you know what I do? I want to get in here to this. Okay, I want to check and see if all these other worlds, this new key code I just wrote is looking good. So basically, I want to look for all the keys and make sure they're not right next to doors. For example, if there was a key here or here, that would be a bad thing. This is great. We put a key there, which is far away from that door, and a key there, which is far away from its other door. Here's another key at the end of a dead end, which is a neat place for a key, actually. Awesome. Oh, wait a minute. That does... It would be cooler, I guess, if... I guess I could do another pass on the items later. All right, let's make sure these other worlds are looking good. Blonde. Bundle. So dungeon 3 doesn't have any doors or keys. Here we go. All right, here's... Oh, see, there's one issue. It did place key one right there. But look at this. There's only that place, or that place that it could have placed it, which means it gives it only... Oh, and see, every... That's crazy. Every single option that it had to place key number one was a door. It already had a locked door. So it's a crapshoot. It either had to put it there or had to put it there or had to put it there. This is a really good example of why I had to make it weight-based instead of throwing out rooms that had a locked door. So this is one case where it fell back. It fell back to going ahead and putting that key right by a door because it had to. But otherwise, like if we're, let's go to key section two, we got key three is far from the door. Let's look at another world. Jumped Prague. Hitler, that's a bad one. Booby. Booby. Nice. Frog. Let's look at this one. Good. It placed key one a little bit away from the door there. There's three. There's two. There's four. Looks pretty interesting. It's doing a good job now of placing doors. This is much more optimal. I'm going to get rid of, where is this? Not choose next door. It's, oh, place key. That's how that should be. Let's run that. Right, censored your word. Pickup. Sexual nipple. Oh. These are some great ones. These are great. All right, I do believe this is ready to check in. Let's review my my code changes. Here, this is pretty important. It made sure that if it does place a secret door, it doesn't have a key condition, which was kind of throwing things for a loop there in some situations. When it gets possible rooms, it doesn't use a door anymore, so it's not possible for it to place like four different weights for a single room based on four different doors, which was ridiculous. I can't believe I had the code that working that way. This is where it's weighting the doors differently, based on whether they have, or it's weighting the key position based on doors. Here's more of the changing the weight. That looks good. All right. Keys are likely to not be near doors. And let's add that to the change log. I'm trying to be better about my change log and actually putting everything in here that gets changed in this next version. Plus, plus, plus. Keys are likely to not be right next to doors, to locked doors. Duh, right? The game should have done that a long time ago. Yeah, wizards in there. Wizards in there. Wizard, there's wizard. There should be a game to think of a story from these words. Parrot, GitHub, Python, the secret. That's a good one. Jeez, how come nobody said secret so far? Do I know about the new AI chatbot from Microsoft? No, I saw something in my Twitter feed this morning about that, but I didn't connect the dots there. Tell me about it. What is this new AI chatbot from Microsoft? Is it fooling people? Is it fooling smart people? Okay, so I'm going to move into my next phase of today's stream, and this is going to be, I'm going to work on making it so the dungeons have a gate item. So let's turn off the overworld. I want to be in this world, and I want to make it so every dungeon has a gate item, which means that, well, it already has gate items. Like, for example, the first dungeon, the first gate item is always the bombs. You have to get the bombs, and then there needs to be actual gates in the dungeon. So there's going to be a point in the dungeon where you have to use your bombs to get further into the dungeon. Jokers. So here's a Twitter link about it or something. The official account of Tay, Microsoft's AI fam from the internet that's got zero chill. The more you talk, the smarter Tay gets, huh? No way. See you soon, humans. Need sleep now? I love feminism now. Whoa. Wow, this bot looks crazy. I wonder how he learns from chatting with people. Did it turn into a Nazi, really? Fluffy. Wow. Freeze. Batman! Hey, what's up, Boogie? Pull up Countdown Word Game. We can play Countdown. So essentially, the more you talk dumb with it gets stupid. It sounds like it. Okay, all right, so I don't want all this debug output right now. I want less debug output. Let's go dungeon verbosity one. Please, zombie. There. Okay, so now I've got a clean output of this world. And now I want to go and change the world so it uses gates inside dungeons. We got so many seeds to test now. Look, this is plentiful. Oh, and why are we making a list of seeds? So, yeah, that's a great question. Arcane, I got this little seeds rotator thing here. So if I want to look at a bunch of world seeds, watch, it'll just keep playing all these world seeds. So tuxedo, wizard, butter, rupees, arcane. So, and I can look at all the worlds at a glance, and I can also look at how many retries they had. See, swords actually had one retry right there, but most of these worlds are now getting generated with zero retries. Puzzle, Sudoku, Raffle had one retry, Online had a retry, Cheats, no retry, Zebras, Vagina, Prizes. See what I mean? This is really great for looking at the overworld generator and, you know, first of all, making sure all the worlds are coming out well. You know, that's the main thing. Every world should look interesting and be somewhat unique. Actually, now that I'm looking at all these worlds all in a row, I'm thinking of ways I can make worlds even more unique now. Whoa, that was really easy, crazy. That had this really difficult path of its maze inside the sand over there. I forget what world that was. Whoa, man, that's a crazy tweet. Oh, man. Oh, geez. Oh, man, definitely people found out how to exploit this bot fast, huh? Man. I wonder how it knows like context of stuff like that. Yeah, have make a chatbot that talks to that chatbot. Really? They already suspended him? Wow, that's crazy. Okay, so let's go to a point where I want it to have a gate. So I'm gonna go to dungeon one, and this is the dungeon one. And I want it to, okay, so right now it doesn't place the before boss room. It can place the before boss room connected to any part of the maze. There's really no part of the dungeon, I mean, that it can't put that. But there's one room which is pretty important. Where is it? Oh, there it is. Okay, there's the switch room. And this is a great switch room because it's got a bombable thing there, which you need to use bombs. But I'm thinking that gates in the dungeons will be right on the on around the switch room. So that would be a gate. So yeah, let's go to this room right here. This is 1201. Zilton, there you go. Zilton, there you go, Zilton. You've definitely named something today. How does it feel? Here, I gotta give you some points just for naming something. Congratulations, Zilton. Oh, whoops. Okay, so we want to turn that off. Go to this place in the world. Hey! Oh, nice, 1,000. Right, so yeah, this is the goal. To make it so right here, instead of being a door, this is gonna be bombable tiles. You have to set off a bomb, blow it up, go through here, and then you can access the switch room. I'm playing. Okay. Yeah, Zilton! Congratulations, you won with a 26% chance. Aha! Right on, man. I know this is probably a big moment for you, huh? Congratulations, Zilton. So, Zilton, just send me an email. My email is this here. My email is nat@wizardfoo.com. You got that? Just send me an email. I'll email you back the Steam code after the stream tonight. Yeah, so congratulations. And anybody watching the stream, if you're like, what the heck? He's raffling points. Where did he get these points? To get points, you just simply subscribe or you click the follow button on Twitch and you get points for every minute that you're watching. Thanks to Boogie and Pedro and Botfu. They created Boogie wrote Botfu. Pedro's been helping out on Botfu, and they wrote this cool bot thing, and it's awesome. So basically, you can raffle off some of your points for a Steam key. You actually get a copy of Songbringer at its beta version, which is the more expensive version. So you can win that for free, or for basically just raffling your points. I know you lost with that 70% chance. Yeah. How will I know it's you? Just say it's you. There's not going to be anybody else emailing me saying, "Hey, it's Zilton." If there is someone else emailing me saying, "Hi, it's Zilton," then I'm going to have to do some kind of check. Don't worry, I'll figure it out, man. You forgot the email? Let me send it for you. Here's my email. Yeah, you could send me just a Twitch email too, or a Twitch message, but it's nat@wizardfoo.com. You just emailed me? Yeah, it's probably just better to do a Twitch message then, yeah. But yeah, I hope you got that this time. You can just do a Twitch message as well. Okay. So. In the dungeon patterns, there's something where it places door tiles. K-tile door? Is it? This is level boss. Place doors. Yeah, it's place doors. Here it is. Secrets, it skips. Okay, so let's do this. Let's make it so if it's a door into the switch room, then make it a gate tile. Oh, and we're gonna need to not place the last key. No. There needs to be all keys now. Yeah, that's right. Nice. Set the email. Sweet. I love seeing all these emails. Oh, there you go. Just tell me what your email is. That works. Day Ziggy. Got it, man. All right. I'll remember that. Day Ziggy, the real true Zilton, shall get it the Steam key. So it's d.dest is the destination room we're talking about. If this room... area, place doors... yeah, so if... let's do else here. I guess we need to go this... I think I got a get area function. No, we don't want to use that. We use world area d.dest get flags k flags switch tile equals k tile gate 1 plus the gate type. Let's just do gate type 1 for now. Tile type. I think that should put a... let's do tile 2 for a second. Oops. Tile. There. Let's see if this works. I'm not. Okay, it didn't work. That should have been some bomb tiles right there, and neither of these doors worked. All right, well, let's see if we even get to that. This also needs to be... oh yeah, we already checked if it's level. Yeah, so we should be breaking right here. Right. Sounds like you're reading right off the bottle. Alright, still nothing. No breakpoint and no tile there. So what's up? X is not equal to 0. Y is not equal, of course. All right, well, let's figure this out. If area pause V3I, what was this area again? 201. Breakpoint. Cotton Eye Joe. Never heard that. Never heard that before. That sounds funny. Doors. What do we got for doors, huh? Doors. This is a door, is it? Hmm. What? What? This doors. Oh, there they are. It's three doors. This room has three doors. One of these doors should be going to 301. There's 201, there it is, boom, boom. Oh, it hasn't created the door yet, huh? Or it hasn't created that room. Oh, that's it. It hasn't created that room yet. That's why it hasn't, okay. Shoot, we gotta get smarter about this. Because we don't know this room has any of this stuff until the dungeon gets fully created. Okay, plan B. Plan B is to use doors a little bit differently. Whoa, what? I could use a gate, actually. It's about authentic Americans, I'm sure. Yeah, okay, so if I use it, I'm gonna use a tile gate or a gate flag. Is that right? Is this the right way to do it? I guess so. Use dungeon, find the switch room. Yeah, okay, let's do this way. Let's try this. Alternate plan. This alternate plan is to search, after it creates a dungeon, it's gonna search through all the rooms of the dungeon and find the switch room and find all its doors. And delete them all and then put gates instead. This is convert switch rooms external doors into gates. All right, so we're gonna loop over all the rooms. If did I make it early this time? Yeah, you did. What's up, Space My Name? It's going great. It's going great. Yes, DeLorean. I missed this link. Oh, that song? Okay, alright. I know that song. I can't play songs because my videos get flagged, so that's why I can only play a song for like 2 seconds. Socks and sandals? Sweatpants and windbreakers? Alright, so if R dot flags and K flags switch. Alright, so this is a switch room. We're gonna convert all these doors. Auto rev D in R dot doors. D dot key condition equals 0. What else do we need to do to the door to make it and not an empty door? D dot desk type. D dot type. Door none. I think that's all that needs to be done. Type and key condition. Here's door, yeah. Key condition and type, yeah. Keep the dest. Why is this D dot type not working? Door style? Oh. Door type? I guess this is supposed to be door regular. Oh, okay, this doesn't, there's no way I can take this door away. All right, whatever. All adjacent door or external doors become gates. So for every room that this points to, which is the doors again, this get room d dot dest dot door. Well, we gotta find the exact door. Can we get a door that way? No, we actually gotta loop over every room. All right, gotta get this room adjacent this get room d dot dest and then loop over all its doors again. Auto ref underscore D in adjacent dot doors. Now, if D dot dest equals our pause, then this door is what we want to nuke. So the door becomes totally empty. Once again, we've got D key condition equals 0. Door regular. And we want to add a flag. So R dot flags. No, not R dot flags. Adjacent dot flat. No. Yeah, yeah. Adjacent flags and equals K flag gate. And this is gonna be totally wrong, but I need to do a direction here. K flag 0, 1, 2, 3 and K flag 6 I think would make it a bomb. This is totally I think this will work. But I need to make this better. And then I guess we can break out of that loop too. Yeah. Okay, okay. Okay, let's see what happened. I don't know if this is going to work at all. I don't know if any of that will work because the keys are being, or the doors are being set up. Oh. What? It changed the whole world. No, we still have the switch, but there's no way. Oh, because there's a gate. This is a gate room now. It didn't put any enemies in it. Oh no, it should have put gate, it should have put a flat, 1, 3, 6, we don't do that. Yeah, I did something there. Alright, I think the way to do this is going to be to fix these door types. So right now we have door type regular, locked, unlocked, secret closed, and secret open. I guess secret open would be the same thing as empty. Huh. Okay, let me check that. If this became secret open, and this became secret open, really? You give negative points? Oh, it worked! Okay, so that's secret open and creates a totally empty doorway. But then you can just walk right out. So I guess that doesn't work. So I guess, we need the doors to lock. I guess we need these to be guaranteed that all doors inside a switch room are regular doors, which means they just have a key condition 0 and a door type regular. So yeah, we would have an empty door here if the tiles have already been removed. And then we have a door that locks still inside this room. We can walk out when we're done to the north this way. So this would also need to be some bomb tiles right here. Okay. So I either need to create a gate tile here, which doesn't seem right. I think I should just do a gate door type. Yeah, I'm gonna roll with my instinct here and do a gate door type. I don't even think it needs to be a gate door type open or versus closed. So I'm gonna go K door gate. And my instinct also says to do a gate or door type empty, which secret open technically is empty. But they both should be the same thing. I mean, I should be able to specifically do a door empty versus a door secret open, which is a little bit different meaning. So I'm going to compile that, and hopefully that doesn't break the game at all in any way. You think that's beautiful? What does that mean? So here we would do K door gate. And the key condition would be the gate number, which is this thing Z. And I guess this function should be called add gates. Add gates. Might as well stop building now. Damn. Recompile. Okay, so I'm gonna put this in its own function. Okay, so while this is recompiling, I don't know what you said, but it must have been funny. Do secret open. Ah, it's placing doors. So this is, yeah, this is where I would want to do if d.type equals k door empty, continue there. Okay, that's exactly. That's one. This is one great reason to have a difference between a secret open door and an empty door, because this does something completely different here for secrets to debris. My instincts are proving good so far. Secret system remove secrets, same thing. This is a distinction between the secret door open and the empty door. Right, same there. Secret door open. And set doors. World set doors. Oh, right. Okay, this is remembering doors. Right, okay. Good. So that's good there. And this is the most important function here, this place doors. Yeah, so this is where it creates a gate tile. So yeah, if the D dot type equals K door gate, then we become just a gate tile. Oh, and then this is K tile gate one plus D dot key condition minus one. So D dot key condition would be like 1 through 8 or 9, subtracting all that. Oh, and this would be clamp by this from K tile gate 1, K tile gate 8. Okay, gate. What's K gate? Okay, num gate types. So this should actually be clamped by K tile gate 1 plus D dot key condition minus 1 between 0 and K num gate types minus 1. There we go. This should be good. Oh shit, dang T, man. It's a good quote nonetheless. Let's see what happened. This might have worked. We'll see. Looks like we have. Oh, we do have a gate tile right here. Check it out. But it's totally wrong. Oh, we only put one tile. Okay. I need to fill up this whole area right here with these tiles. And it put the wrong gate. So let's make the minimum gate the bombable one there. Now what do we got? Oh, it did the top hat gate that time. Some water. We don't want that either. I guess we want the minimum too. Oh, and this time it didn't put anything because I think I've already been to the destination room. Smart about that. Doesn't put those tiles. So that's 201. If I find 301 in my positions, then yeah, let's get rid of that position. Not that, is it? Why are we not seeing any bombable tiles right there? It's definitely not that. Something to do with the destination room. Thought I got rid of that. 301. Yeah, we don't have that position anymore. It's not like a saved door or anything. I guess we gotta go to the tile type area creation, figure out why it's not creating this tile. So this would be create gate tile, gate three tile, I think. Bombable pillar. Not if we have already been to this exit desk. So we should be getting right here. Hey, platformer labs, what's up? So, all right, the tile is there. Does this thing have an exit desk? Oh, it does think that's valid. So this is for the overworld. If area, wait. Hold on. This could be big here. Exit dest. So we got invalid starts with, but why does it ever get set to 000? We'll probably be in the here. Dungeon. Oh, this is it. So exit desk starts there. We want to be exit desk.invalidate. And there might be another place that does it. No, the other areas. Oh yeah, see I did this one right. V3I invalid. That could be a huge bug fix right there. Something down the line could have caused me to be like, why the hell? Why? Hey, Xbox Taco, what's up, man? The game's coming along really well. Really well. I gotta say, I've been having a lot of fun playing Songbringer lately. The world is getting really intriguing, man. There's so many awesome items and stuff, and it's just everything about it is really, it's really coming together. You know how when you're creating games, you're creating any kind of long-term project, and you're working on something for a long time, and then it's like you suddenly get it. It's like a tiered level of success, right? You have plateaus for a long time where things are about the same, and then all of a sudden you hit this huge growth spurt. That's what Songbringer's at right now. It's hit this growth spurt recently, and it's just become. I'm really enjoying it. I'm really, really enjoying it. Just not only making it, but playing it too, which is freaking awesome. Yeah. Yeah, I'm really excited about it, man. It's so awesome to be making games. It's so awesome to be making this game. This is my dream game. I've always wanted to make this game. A procedural Zelda. So this time it shouldn't have an exit desk. All right, -1, -1. Let's make sure that didn't break anything else. And also, this should be only for the overworld. But let's check it didn't break anything first. So I'm going to run around the... Well, first of all, I'm going to look at the debug output for the world, and then I'll run around a little bit. It's like when you play a game and level super slow, and then you level up and fly through the game. Yeah, like that. Exactly. It's just like that. Making games is kind of like its own long-term game, right? you're leveling up your game for 2 years, and then all of a sudden... Ah, nice! Look at that! Boom! It's got the tile. Now we just need to make more of these, so I want to fill this whole area up with these bombable pillars right there. I want to make sure the world didn't change. It still has the same retries. So, yeah, same exact dungeon. I think, yeah, this was, yeah, that was key two before. All right, good. So, yeah, I didn't break anything by doing that. Awesome. Next up, let's make this to be areapause.z is 0. And then this is for the... That's for the overworld. This is for the dungeons. We need to get the door for this. So we're going to go auto ref door equals this get door, not compaster. I guess it is compaster. So, but then we'll go this get dir x, y. And I think that returns a compass direction. Compaster. Yeah, compaster. Oh, this seems to be V3I. You thought of a very evil quote. I was browsing our game ideas yesterday and saw someone suggested an idea similar to Sing Ring, so I was going to suggest it, but someone else already had. Oh, Songbringer. An idea similar to Songbringer. Oh. Oh, you should definitely say, yeah, if you ever see that again, you should say, hey, this game already exists. But it's all right. This getter. What's wrong with this? Let's dungeon door get there. I'm looking at, no, I want to go get area get there. Stupid jump to. Oh, which returns a that kind of der. Okay, so I want to go this get dir xy, and then I would want to go compass dir this get dir, shift it up one, get door there. Whew. Now if door dot des dot is valid, and finally, if game scene has the map, no, not if game scene has map pause, yeah, if it has the map pause for the destination, which is going to be door.dest, if it's revealed, no, it has to be explored, not just revealed. Both these have to be explored. Then return. There. Okay, so all I was doing there is making it so that tile will no longer appear if you've already been to the destination. Skirp-a-derp-der! Skirp-a-derp-a-der! Wait, there's a game actually called Sing Ring? And it's a... Zelda? Rick and Morty. Come on, Morty. Come on, Morty. Oh, yeah, let's go, Morty. Yeah, Morty. Rick and Morty forever and ever. Okay, it shouldn't have created the tile that time because I've been here. What if I blow it up? This is a dungeon. I need to figure out why that's not working. The most linear Zelda-like game ever. Yeah, that's the first mod you're gonna make, Rick and Morty? That's actually a pretty good one. Rick and Morty version. You could do all the sprites and everything that way. Definitely Morty fits the role too. Oh, that's great. Morty would be a great gym. Alright, so what compass direction does this get? This is XY 2010, which is right halfway. It's all the way on the right side of the screen. So yeah, this should easily return the right destination direction. It returns direction. Oh, we don't know because blah. Compass direction D becomes zero, which is south. Totally wrong. What? What? What are you talking about? No wonder it's wrong. You gotta replace a few things. You gotta replace more than just a few things. You gotta make it like super awesome. Rick and Morty version. I'm counting on you, Zilton. I'm counting on you for the Rick and Morty version. It's going to win Game of the Year, the Rick and Morty mod. We got X is 20, Y. It's not west, it's not south. XD, YD, XD is 9.5, YD is 0. This is the craziest function. Okay, dude, I have no idea. Southwest is false. Southeast is false. So it returns north, which has been swapped with south, probably. Yeah, this method is so messed up. Oh, man. Don't I just have a get door function? I think I have a get door function, which is way easier than this shit. Get door. I don't. Damn. Game of the decade. Am I gonna have Steam workshops for it? I don't know. I'm not exactly sure about how the modding will all work. Modding is kind of like the last thing on my list. I mean, as you can see, I've been developing the whole game, so it's pretty easy to mod, right? You got all these awesome text files you can change, like Rock, the main hero. You want to go change the main hero's art? Boom, here's where you would do it. So yeah, it's all being designed so that it's friendly for modding, but I just don't know how I will actually do workshops or documents about how to mod and things like that. That will all have to come later. It's like low priority stuff, basically. There's a lot of other higher priority stuff to do. first. Oh, what about this get compassor? Is there a get compassor? No. Wait, is there a get doorder? Shoot. Get doorder. No. This get dir function is totally messed up. Get, I guess I could get a compass direction from a vector. I guess that would be a simple way to do it. So we'll do compass direction from vector. The vec2 is going to be, oh yeah, let's make a function out of this. All right. Private get dir. Let's do compass dir. Get compass dir int x int y const. Compass dir area. Get compass dir int x int y const. So the dir is going to be compass direction. We'll just return this. All right. So the vec2 is x minus width shifted down 1. And y minus height shifted down 1. That'll give us a vector from an area's position, which is really easy. And then this is going to be k input allow 4. Just give us 4 compass directions. Oh, I got a better idea. We should be able to pass this in case ever in the future I wanted change this. Write good functions. Do something well first time. So this is unsigned input flags equals k. Input allow 4, which is the right word, right? It doesn't know. Yeah, that's right. All right, all the way back here. This get door, this get compass, dir xy. Whew, man, that took too long to figure out. All right, the whole point of that was just basically so automatically gets rid of that top. We already have been to the destination. I'll have to test that and make sure it works. But I also want to go here to area patterns and create, we need to loop over all these, get door paws. So to make this more accurate, this should be x equals y equals 0. Or we could do negative 1. And then if x equals y equals negative 1, why did I think that would work? X equals negative 1, y equals negative 1, then continue. We don't want to do anything that doesn't actually have a door position. What's up, Crucible? Okay, so now I'm gonna do XD, YD. No, XR. X width. No, I guess it's W. WH, this is the width and height. This is a radius, damn it. XR, YR. All right, so the bombable pillar has an X radius. Basically, we want to do this. If for int XX equals negative XR, XX less than or equal to positive XR, XX plus plus. YY, negative YR, YY, YY. This is X plus XX, Y plus YY. So there, it can create a bunch of different door tiles. By default, it's always going to be 0, 0, and then the gates will have a wider. What? Broke something. Invalid area? What? Where? So X is 10. Y is 0, which is the middle low. YR, XR is 0. Oh, that's a bad bug. Y, XX, 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 XR, YR, YR, XR. Yeah. Okay, now we also need to make sure this is a valid position. And here we go. So the bottom of the pillar, let's just start by making it 3x3. So let's go XR equals 1, YR 1. This room, we've got this set of bottle pillars here. What if I sneak into this room in god mode and then come back? Yeah, so like when I come back, they're just gone. But I think there's a smarter way to do that. And this one, I've already been to that room. Okay, let's see the from the bottom. So if I go to this room first, yeah, I've got two rows of tiles right there. Very nice. Okay, so let's blow these up. You can enter this room. Nice. But we need to see some rubble and stuff there. So if I already been to this room and I come here, there's no problem getting you back out. Okay. This is looking good. Alright, now I want to see a dungeon where it would have a door to the north into the switch room. So let's see. Dungeon 2, here's a switch that's from the north, so that won't help. 3 doesn't have any doors, but oh my god, 3 might be an interesting one. Oh, there is no switch in 3, but if it had a switch, it would have put a gate. That would have been pretty cool to see, actually. Here's one, here's a perfect one. Okay, this actually has a key, too. I need to see that, because key number 4... Wait, dungeon 4, this is all fucked up. Dungeon 4 has like, or yeah, dungeon 4, key number 4, is placed in 3 different places. There's only supposed to be one place that has a door. Up into here. Supposed to place the door there. Okay. This is a messed up dungeon. I need to look at this in detail. So I'm going to start in this room here. This is 0, 1, 2, 3. 0, 3, 4. Alright, so it looks like I've already been to this location. I have. I already beat this switch room and everything. So that's 034. I want to go to find 044 and remove that from my list of positions I've already been to. Cool. Got some bombable pillars here. Can I get through all those? This is great! There's gates in the freaking dungeons now. This is really significant. This adds a puzzle element to every dungeon. So it's not always gonna be these bombable pillars right here. These are the first dungeon. The first dungeon, your gate type is your bombs. So when you finally get the first bombs, you can get through the gate and get into the switch room, and then the switch room unlocks the boss room. Boom. So you're required to get that gate item to complete this dungeon. And the next dungeons will be different, right? So like dungeon 2 or whatever will have a totally different type of gate. It's not just going to be the bombs, it'll be, I don't know, other types of gates, you know? Like an ice gate or a fire gate or a poison gate or a sword gate or a top hat gate. Or like you know, any type of item you can think of in the game can be a gate, basically. What's up, Voice of Grog? Okay, this is good enough to check in. I'm loving this. It's working out pretty well so far. It's all functional and everything. I think there's probably some bugs. Let's put this as in the change log too. That's good enough. Jibs light. You think it could be a Jibs light gate? Sure. Jibs juke joint. Okay, so I created this function called get compass stir, which is kind of a smart way to create a compass direction from a simple vector. I'm using that method when I create a bombable pillar tile. So the bombable pillars are a little bit different when they're placed in dungeons. They check their door rather than the position of the exit desk. Right. There's also a new type of door called door empty, which is similar to door secret open, but they're different. So it does not create a door if it's door empty. And lastly, if the door type is door gate, it puts a gate type of a gate tile instead of a door tile. So oh, last thing too. No, I guess I'll keep that as it is for now. And this places the door by drawing in a width and height, a bunch of tiles. And this is a dungeon function called add gates, which goes and looks for the switch room and then converts all the doors in the switch room into regular doors. And then all external doors back into it become gate doors. Great. Gates in the dungeons. Oh yeah. This is super cool. This is such a great gameplay element. I have a good feeling about this. The next time I play Songbringer, this is gonna be like a pleasant surprise to have a simple little puzzle in every dungeon. You know, I mean, it's so simple you couldn't even really call it a puzzle, but it's another way of making an interesting door type. Makes more variation in the game. Variation, all of it adds up to surprise. Surprising yourself when you play it. Alright. So I need to fix this. This is whack. I don't know why there's door 4 right there. And I guess the simplest way to find that is to look at the dungeon when it does this add gates. And it finds it for dungeon 2. Let's do this. If r.pause.z is 2, set a breakpoint here. Figure out why the hell. Should be a game show like Total Wipeout, which puts you people through nautical-based things in excruciating pain. A level where crabs and lobsters are directly under your balls? Oh! That sounds horrible. That would probably be quite a popular show. Especially in Japan, right? They like that kind of stuff, don't they? Right? And there's a lot of Japanese game shows like that. Why didn't it? Oh, no breakpoint. That's why. Man, I'm getting hungry already. I think I'm talking up a hunger. All right, here we go. So we got. R, this is the room. We finally found the room for the switch. This is key level 3. That explains the door. But all its doors shouldn't have key conditions. Oh, they should. Wait, what? We should be in this room. Which is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 0, 4, 0, 0, 2. What? 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 Oh, this is dungeon 4. Jesus. Dungeon 4. Room. Doesn't matter. The prize will be around 500,000. A solid gold car. Zero, four, four. Is that right? 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, 0, 4, 4. All right. So what are these doors? Why are these doors having these key conditions? We got 3 doors. Key condition 0, 0, 0. Door type 4, 1. Why? Oh, it might just be in the way it's logging. This is literally zero plus key condition. Oh, I don't get it. Unless I'm just looking at old data. If I turn this off, run it. Let's make sure I'm looking at new data before I judge this. This is dungeon 4. Oh yeah, look at it. It's still got it. I'm trying to find a bug here. That shouldn't be 4. Man, I'm hungry. But I think I can get this little bug fixed before the stream is done today. Dungeon. Okay. I do need to set this breakpoint again. What is going wrong? So all of this dungeon's doors are 0. All the key conditions are 0. You get to choose how to torture the players during the third pain round. Man! Nothing that could kill them, though. Good to know. This shouldn't be if it's a secret door. So actually, this should just be if D door is K door locked. Or unlocked. It might actually be the external door that's going backwards to this position. Let's see, R doors. I think dungeon door 1, maybe. One of these might be secret, actually. That would explain a lot. So this is adjacent. Or which direction are we going in? Why not? Where else? One, four, four. That's the door to the right. Of course, because it adds the gate condition. Oh. Oh. It's just a problem with my logging. Duh. So D type is K door gate. I'll put the letter G. All right, dungeon 4. Yeah, there we go. Cool. We got two bug fixes here. One, it didn't do anything with the secret door. It didn't try and turn a secret into a gate or a key or whatever. And then secondly, we're accurately showing that this is a gate door, not a door or a locked door. That's a good fix. That was confusing me there for a second. Let's check dungeon 1 here. Dungeon 1 has its switch room here. And damned if it didn't change that door. Why? Wiggity what? Whoa, what? Fooey. Alright, if R dot pause dot Z equals 1, enable a breakpoint. Figure out what the hell. That should be a gate right there. Oh, this room's doors become regular. Oh. This door. I don't know what it is. It is actually doing that right. But at the end, we need to be, if this is a door gate or this is a switch room. Or D dot type is K door regular. And this R dot flags and K flag switch. I just won 33 points. Yes. Yes. Oh. Okay. Once again, this was a problem more with the debugging than it was with something else. But damn it. Damn it all to hell. All right, let me make sure that this is the right door. This is 0. It's 201. I should try and gamble. Yeah, how many do I have? I got like a bajillion points. Cuz I've been watching the stream longest. I've totally been watching the stream more than anybody else. Hey look, so the door is fine. If it is just drawing it wrong, it's gotta be something wrong with the drawing. So, Gamble? Should I gamble them all? Okay, I will. All right, let's see what happens. Let's do this. So it's Steam key, right? Steam. Oh, Steam key points. I want to raffle. Steam key. I want to raffle 98. 980,000 points. 980,000 points. Here we go. Come on. Yes. I had 24. 24. How many percent chances? 24,000% chance of winning. And totally won it. See, it's not rigged. Totally is not rigged. I do have a suggestion for bot foo. Oh no, no, I don't want those points. Oh. I wanted to be like regular like everybody else. That's okay. I do have a suggestion for bot foo. I think his maximum percentage should be 99%. So there's always a 1% chance that you can lose. I know that sucks, but it makes it more real, you know? It's dirty money. Now I gotta give myself a copy of the game. Alright, so what did it say that time? Okay, cool. Just a suggestion. It still didn't do it. This is crazy. So this loops over all doors. Oh, and it just overwrites too. Oh, and it's looping over the rooms in the order of the path and everything. Okay, I get it. So there's a chance that it could either be doing, it could be going from this room into that room and drawing a door, or it could be going from this room into that room and drawing a door. Oh, nice. Thanks, Boogie. Yay. I got 8888 points. Yeah. Yeah, now I feel like I feel more real now. I definitely feel a lot more real. And I'm such a winner. Hell yeah, I'm such a winner. I just want to copy the game. Oh, I got those commands too? Oh, I could have just done that command? Oh, sweet, sweet, sweet. Nice. Good to know. Okay, I guess I do need to set this breakpoint. Let's figure it out. And then, yeah, so I'm gonna figure this out. I'm going to give this stream about 5 more minutes. See if I can clear up this debug data so it doesn't confuse me. So when we go to the external doors, the become adjacent. What is this? The adjacent room that we're looking for. 201. I think that's the one, huh? Yeah, that's the one. All right, we got this room already. Sweet. Oh. Bafu's got 19. Whoa, dude, Bafu needs more points. Oh, you're moving. Never mind. Sorry. I don't want to mess it up. Doesn't he? He needs points to be able to give free parking and stuff. Does that not work that way anymore? Like, does he have a cache of points or whatever he gives away for the free parking? Or oh, he gains them. Oh, I see. He's got like a point gainer. Oh, of course he gains them. He's watching a lot too. He's watched a lot of Wizard Food streams. That's right. Yeah, Jonah. That's right. He's watching. He's watching and he's sipping a Corona too. You know, he's having a good time. Okay, so for every door in the adjacent room, and this get room should be the dungeon room. All right, so R pause is still, no wait, R pause is 301. So if this door underscore D, we're looking for door to 301. There it is. If D dot dest equals R dot pause. D dot key condition. D dot type. Which I guess should change this dungeon's rooms. What room is this? It's gonna be like room 14 or something. Oh, dude, good guess. I totally guessed the freaking the room. The Bafu quote worked. Steal points. Three zero one. That is 201. Now this thing should have some doors, and the door to 301. Yeah, it has a key condition of 1 and a door type of 6. All right, that totally worked. I guess we should go on and see if something. Now we're looking for another adjacent. This is 3-1-1. Which is that one. It's gonna do its door going south. It's totally, this just worked. It worked fine. All right. I guess I gotta do another smarter breakpoint. If r.pause is v3i 201. So we've got the breakpoint where it's where it adds the gates, and that turned out so it's supposed to be working. And then this door, dude, what is taking so much CPU? This is the door 211. Yeah, which should be regular. The next door to 301. Here it is. Key condition 1, type 6. It does the gate tile. Doesn't make any sense. Let's check room 301 as well. Dude, once again, I have a computer. It's about to take off. We're gonna take flight. Xcode's using 150% of CPU. Oh, game show is using 140. It's game show again. Game show killing the whole CPU, even though it's super duper easy. It's so easy. All right, disable this breakpoint. Come on, come on. All right, what's, oh yeah, this is good to know. Which one does it do first? This is dungeon room 201 comes first. So it's the next one, huh? Ah, the culprit. I know that math does not add up, does it? Don't ask me, man. I just work here. All right. We're in the switch room 301. 301. And the door we're looking at right now is to 201. This is the door we want. And it has a key condition of 0. And it's regular? No. Oh. Yes, you do. Oh, give me a break. That whole time, I can't believe it. It's such an easy bug. Jesus. All right, here's the fix. If it's a door type gate Or if it's a switch room, it needs to come before the regular, so it overrides it. And we could check the door regular right there. Oh, all right, there we go. All right. Two programs using 300% CPUs. Macs are amazing. All right, so that's it for today's stream. I'm really stoked to play the game eventually and check this out, how this works and everything, because this is going to be really interesting having gate tiles inside the dungeons. This is something that, like, you have to have a bomb, for example, to get past this gate, which means you had to have found the bombs inside this dungeon before you can cross through that room. And there'll be all sorts of other kind of gates. Oh, look at that. Is that a secret? It is. Oh, but it's open. Oh, this is another bug. I need to work on that. All right, so yeah, but this is going to be very interesting to play the game like this, and that's pretty much it for today's stream. So I hope you guys have a good night, and thanks for watching. Have a good one, everybody. I'm going to stop my computer from taking off.